In this episode, I want to do a follow-up to episodes that I've done several other times, and this really is a follow-up in many ways to all of the episodes I've done on lambdas as well, I guess. And the idea is that we want to talk about how visitors work for visit. And I've already covered this a few times, but let's see if we can really distill this down to the essence of what is possible today. Now, sorry for the very bright scene change here, but before I continue, I should remind you that I am giving a workshop on October 10th at C++ Under the Sea in Breda, Netherlands on ConstExpr. And feel free to sign up for that, of course. And also on September 9th and 10th, I am giving a C++ Best Practices workshop at NDC Tech Town in Kongsberg, Norway. Now, these are both 2024. Let's say you've got a variant of some sort. And you want to be able to operate on this thing. As C++ developers, we are honored to contribute to self-driving technology, simplify lives with embedded devices, support financial ecosystems, and assist traders with trading bots. To keep up with the pace of development, we need tools that help us work quickly and effectively. CLion is a powerful JetBrains IDE for C and C++ that makes this challenge its main goal, integrating code analysis, refactoring, and the best ecosystem tools into our day-to-day development. Use CPP Weekly CLion to get 25% off when you purchase a new CLion subscription or renew your existing one. This is what the standard visit utility is for. Now, you give visit a callable, and then you give it a list of variants, and it can do multiple dispatch or multi-method dispatch, depending on how you're used to this being described, but that is literally a topic for a future video that I have planned right now. I'll probably record it shortly after I record this one, but who knows what order I will air them in. I have visit, and I want to visit this thing, and I want to pass some sort of visitor to it. Now, if all of these things have the same interface and you want to do the same thing with them, regardless of the type of thing that was returned, a generic lambda is absolutely brilliant for this. So I might do something like this. Now, I can't directly print this thing because I don't know what type it actually contains at runtime. And of course, I got this wrong. I even read out to you what the order of parameters would be, and then I put them in the wrong order. As you can see, this generates an awful lot of code, and part of the problem is that standard print is not nearly as efficient as the print that we get from libformat. But fortunately, we can get the simple format print that is able to generate considerably smaller binaries and compile shockingly faster if we just enable that feature in Compiler Explorer. Well, anyhow, so this is the idea. Now, if I were to try to execute this, variant doesn't actually return a thing, but let's go ahead and have it return something like this. And we can see that 4.2 is printed. Okay, and the compiler is actually able to figure all of this stuff out at compile time, which is pretty crazy. It just literally loads the value 4.2 into the pointer that it passes to format vprint. But that's really not the point of this particular episode. What we want to do is perhaps do a different thing depending on the type that the variant contains. So this is in the case where I need to do something less generic. And what you need is a callable thing that has all of the different call operators overloaded. So now I've declared this type, I have called it visitor, and it has three different call operator overloads. And now I can pass this as the callable that I actually want my visit function to execute. And I'm doing those empty braces right there to actually default instantiate an object of type visitor. And it has these three call operators, and they should probably actually be const. And let's go ahead and do that. And as of C++ 23, these could actually be static as well, but that's not really going to change the meaning of this code. But this is a lot of work. And doing this whole call operator overload thing is kind of annoying, and this is basically what lambdas do for us. So lambdas are types created by the compiler, they're closure types, created by the compiler for us that have the properties that we declare them to have, and they are structs that have a call operator overload, and if we know this, then we can take advantage of this, and we can do something like this. Now, this at its most basic level, I am declaring a type called visitor. It is a variadic template that has a bunch of things that I have called callables. Now, these are required to be types, they cannot be values. We've talked about value parameters to templates in a recent episode as well. Now, I am doing variadic inheritance. So this visitor thing derives from all of the callable things that it has been created with. And then I am doing a variadic using declaration. And I am saying, take the call operators from all of these callables and pull them into visitor's namespace. So I can call the call operator on visitor, and I will call whichever one of these callable things actually works for this case. This is the latest and greatest version. This is C++ 20. I don't have to do anything else from here. And I can update my call to visit now to be like this. Okay, this relies on so many language features. First of all, it relies on C++ 11's variadic templates. Second of all, it relies on C++ 17's variadic using, and C++ 98's multiple inheritance, and C++ 98's call operator overloading, and C++ 17's class template argument deduction. But in previous versions of this that we've covered on this show, we had to do a deduction guide to teach the compiler how to deduce what these types are for aggregate types, because I don't have a constructor of any sort. If I had a constructor, then the compiler has been able to, since C++ 17, do this class template argument deduction thing. But in C++ 20, it's able to also do it, even though I don't have an explicit constructor here, which is amazing. So it's able to deduce for me what all of these base classes are, and each of the base classes is a lambda type, then it is able to merge all of these things in together in literally the most efficient way possible. There's no copies or moves or anything happening here. All these lambdas are being constructed in place in the base class locations for the visitor object. Well, if that doesn't make sense to you, then it's a new area for you to be looking and researching in as you're learning more about C++, because this episode is already longer than I expected it to be. But there you go. This is revisiting visitors for visit. And the idea is that you can, as of C++ 20, make this into a very, very simple utility. It makes writing visitors much easier. And there is an example of this on the CBP reference page for standard visit, if you want to also go and look it up there. So thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to subscribe.